Are you sure this is the best place to study?
Totally. No one ever comes in here anyway.
Okay then. Let's start with math. Y equals the integral of sine x over x dx. Come on, it's really easy. Come on, y equals the integral of sine x dx. What is it? This is kindergarten stuff.
What is sine x?
Fine, we'll go back to that one later. Go to the next one. If a cube plus b cube equals c cube, and a, b, c are positive numbers, then prove that a equals b equals c.
Do people actually do this shit for a living?
Gus, you aren't taking this seriously.
I'm sorry, Susan, but what am I going to need this for later in life? I don't need to know about invisible numbers and the Pythagorean theorem.
It doesn't matter, Gus. I need you to pass this test, and math is 20% of your grade.
Well, why does it have to be so hard?
It's not that hard. Now let's get to studying. Now, what is the square root of pi? You've got to be kidding.
This summer, one woman has the guts to speak her mind.
What the hell is all this camera equipment in here for? In my day we did the Charleston Heston on the Broadway stage. Now we got these fancy gizmos and what? Talking pictures. What an outrage.
Oh boy, the Betty Boop arcade game has just been released. Scrub that ass, scrub that ass.
Okay, Lily, there he is. You just have to go over to him and talk to him.
But I'm too socially awkward.
Oh, come on, that never stopped Helen Keller. You just go over to him and tell him what you already know in your heart.
Okay.
Boop boop dee boop.
Hello, Matt.
Get your stinky, orange peel, compost heap of the face out of my eye line, Lily. I already told you how much I hated you, now get lost. That happens on occasion.
I'm so humiliated now. It's obvious I should just give up. There might be other guys. I heard Larry's into some weird shit.
Lily, you can't give up. You have to keep fighting.
You know, Mrs. N, I'm starting to think maybe you aren't the right person to be giving me advice on love.
That's nonsense. You just have to bite your lip and go in for the kill.
No, Mrs. N, I think I should just go.
I have to do something. I need them grandbabies. Matt, how could you?
What? It's not even alcoholic. I mean, it's slightly, but you know.
Not that. I mean, how could you say such horrible things to Lily?
Oh, come on, Ma, it's Lily.
So what? You know, Matt, when I was in school, I wasn't a popular girl either.
Shocking.
And I feel for Lily. She obviously comes from a broken home. She clearly has no real friends, and no guy could possibly love her. Plus, she's not very smart.
No, you're saying even worse things about her.
Matt, I think if you really gave Lily a chance, it could turn out to be something special. Who knows, she might even be your love interest.
Come on, Ma, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Matt, I want you to go on a date with Lily.
That's how I feel about it.
Matt, why do you have to be so superficial?
I'm not superficial, I just like giant boobs and unrealistically perfect faces.
Matt, for your own mother, can you please just go on one date with her? Even if it's just for comic relief?
Fine. But you owe me.
Okay, I'll take down the security cameras.
Even the one in the bathroom.
Okay. And that is how I accidentally switched your homework with Stephen Hawking's lab notes. Well, looks like we have about 2 minutes left in class. So please just sit at your desks quietly.
Susan, can I see you for a moment?
Ooh, someone's in big trouble. Oh.
Yes, Mrs. Banana Swallows?
How's Gus coming along?
Well, to be honest with you, we haven't done a whole lot of studying. It turned out to be harder to teach him than I thought.
That's a bit puzzling, Susan, since today is Wednesday, and if you still want to get out of the experiment, you'll have to get him to pass. You understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Get back to your seats.
So I was like, shit, Amigas ain't be crossing my hole.
You remember what we said, you little bitch? You cut us open, we'll cut you up even more.
You really think we're playing here, you daft cunt?
I don't think she knows how to listen. Because she doesn't seem to get the fucking message.
How about we make it crystal clear for you, you little skank? You try to get that knife anywhere near us, and we'll do you one better. We'll come after that lame-ass boyfriend Kermit of yours. We're not afraid of murdering our own kind.
We'll split his throat nice and good, you'll see.
You'll see.
So my wife started watching that show Breaking Bad, and now she wants to open a meth lab.
Seriously?
Yeah, but she doesn't really know how to make meth, and so she keeps passing out from all the chemicals that she doesn't know anything about.
Gus.
Hey Susan. What's up?
Gus, I've been looking all over for you. We need to get some studying in.
What's the rush? We got 2 days.
Exactly. We only have 2 days before the test. We need to study all we can.
Oh, come on, don't worry. I always cram just enough at the last minute to be just fine on the test.
Gus.
Wait a minute.
So I'm sure you already understand full well, we hire only the best and most experienced at our company. Could you describe your previous work experience?
Well, I like to refer to myself as a rape artist by trade.
Rape artist? You mean rapist?
Please, it's so much more than that.
What is the matter with you? Why would you do that for a living?
It's dirty work, but somebody's gotta do it.
You're a menace, Gus Freeman. You're a lousy good for nothing. We don't take slackers like you at our prestigious company. And I won't be surprised if you aren't hired anywhere. Be it fast food, garbage collecting, or a witch doctor in the Booming Asian district. Now, get out. Slacker. 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 Booming Asian district.
Oh no, please.
Gus, can you keep it down?
Go back to sleep.
Can you at least unchain me?
I guess I really am going to have to cut open those frogs. What should I do, Einstein? You never help anyone, Einstein. You're so selfish.
Susan, I've been thinking about what you said. You're right, there's only a short window until the big test, and I've been putting you through a lot of worry over it. It's time I buckle down and get to studying.
I guess I have been pretty hard on you, Gus. I just don't want to have to cut up those poor frogs. Each time I think about it, I feel like I'm performing an autopsy on Kermit himself. Plus, 2 frogs are going to kill me if I do anything.
Okay then. Let's get to work. First things first though. Einstein, tell me what Cyanex means.
Coming up next, Beverly Hills Cop. Followed by, Ruthless People.
2 gut-grind old movies in 1 day? Come on TV box, I'm only one woman.
Mom, I am going to go on that date with she who must not be named.
Okay sweetheart, remember to be nice and drivel. She's a nice girl.
Whatever.
Now to think of God crying cold falling through my ceiling.
Solid maker, son. I'm afraid I just can't take life anymore. I will always be lonely and miserable.
Lily, it's time for that date.
Oh, Matt. Coming right down. I'm so happy you asked me out. This is seriously a dream come true. I almost thought this day would never come, but now, here he is, my knight in shining armor coming to save his beautiful princess. I just wish I grew out my hair longer. Oh, Matt, where shall we go?
I was thinking we should go to the law factory.
Swell idea, Lancer.
Whom it may concern. Okay, Gus, our first test for our epic transition is U.S. history. The subject, 1949 to 1989.
That's 40 years. How are we going to learn it all in that time?
Don't worry, Gus. I know just what we need. Harry Truman, Doris Day, Red China, Gummy Ray, South Pacific, Walter Winkel, Joe DiMaggio, Joe McCarthy, Richard Nixon, Studebaker, Television, North Korea, South Korea, Marilyn Monroe. Buddy Holly, Ben Hur, Space Monkey, Mafia, Hula Hoo, Casper. Excel is a no-go. YouTube, Sigmund Eve, Payala, Kennedy, Cubby Checker, Psycho, Bell Den and the Congo.
Hey, I think I might be getting the hang of this.
You give it a bye, Gus.
Okay, I will. Hemingway, Iceman, Spanker in the Spankland, Dylan, Berlin, Bay of Pigs and Bayzan, Lawrence of Arabia, British People Mania, Omis, John Glenn, Listen Beats, Patterson. Pope Paul, Malcolm X, what the hell is Science X? JFK, Blown Away, what else do I have to say?
Gus, I think you're ready.
You're right, Susan. Nothing can stop me now. I am going to ace that test.
I believe in you, Gus.
Tonight? That's great. Just remember, if you're Indian, Middle Eastern or Jewish, you must leave immediately. I am serious. Anyway, I was reading the Daily Fartown this morning, and I read that King Richard III died. I was saddened by the death, especially after the news broke out that Jews were released from Auschwitz. So I got the news from my doctor, it's official. I have breast cancer. Anyway, I heard that gays are getting married. That's pretty weird, huh?
Hello, welcome to Talkout.Town. Our top story, major scandal involving new starlet Gloria Reed, who during her stand-up bit at Carnegie Hall she made some off-color offensive joke about homosexuals. Our man on the scene, Jenny, is interviewing people on the streets asking them of their opinion.
How did you feel about the comments that were made?
Bill Nye the Science Guy is not a real scientist. He's a Ghostbuster dentist who performs exorcisms on people for a nominal fee.
She's a menace to society, a rival to the LGBT. We have to overthrow her, see, and get her out of our community. I'm not saying this because I like breasts. Stop accusing me, is this a test?
This is absolutely dreadful, what a terrible role model.
You know, I think it's just terrible how people think they can just say whatever they want and people will be okay with it. Miss Gloria Reed needs to understand that words can hurt.
My brother happens to be a fag.
Exactly. I highly doubt her career will ever recover from this blow.
So what I was thinking we can do today, is when she comes in, we tell her we're going to chop off her father's head.
No, no, no! That's much too easy! Remember, she hasn't seen her parents in 6 years! She wouldn't care what we did to them! We need to say we'll blow half of her uncle's face off!
How would that even work? How do you blow half of someone's face off?
It can happen, trust me!
Look, I don't think that will scare her. It'll probably just make her laugh.
Oh, like you know how to sound intimidating!
What's that supposed to mean?
You don't scare her.
Bullshit, I'm scarier than all of you. You're just too stupid to notice.
Oh yeah? Then how come she never bursts into tears when you talk to her?
Because she has no estrogen.
What do you mean?
Oh yeah, I heard about that. Her endocrine system is totally out of whack.
By the way, how are you even alive? You're cut in half.
I'm like an earthworm. One part of me is cut in half. Now there are two of me.
Hello, people. I'm this fine gentleman. Please don't let fake people beat me.
What a terrible life we have. And here we are spending our time threatening a sexually ambiguous schoolgirl.
No, I kinda want to be dissected.
Alright, time to go to work. I'll see you when I get home at midnight.
Bye, sweetheart.
Hello, my dear Anna.
Hello, Ed. It's a beautiful day today.
I know, thank God it's Friday. Friday.
Time for the big test Susan is afraid of.
So Susan, ready to cut open Mr. Froggy?
Just so you know, Gary, I won't be partaking in the experiment today.
Oh yeah? Good luck failing then.
I don't have to. So Gus, are you ready for the test?
Yup, I'm ready. I took a note from athletes and made sure I didn't rape the night before so my mind would be clear.
Okay, students. Change of plans. Looks like we won't be doing our assignment today. Instead, we're going to take a test over Billy Joel's hit song, We Didn't Start the Fire.
But I don't know the song.
Gee, Gary, looks like you should have done your studying.
I am going to drop out of school if I don't pass.
Yes, so please take out a pencil.
Boy, this ending sure makes me...
Epilogue.
Excuse me, ma'am. We had a report that someone at this residence was running a meth lab.
Oh yes, that's me. Would you like some meth? I am giving them away at half the price of our competitors. Right this way, please. What type of meth would you like?
These are just toxic chemicals and flour.
Perhaps your best course would be to tread lightly.
Whoopi.
Mm-hmm.